Hey everyone, it's Lisa from Canine Clips Dog Grooming Tips. This is Maple, and she is a Shih-Tzu Bichon cross dog breed, and she's come in for her full groom. She has been on my difficult doggy grooming list there, as she has been a little bit difficult with her paws the very first time she came to me. This is her third time, so she's calming down a bit, so we'll see how she does. And I will attach her video at the end of this video so that you can see what her first groom was like to how she is now. I'm hoping much better, but we'll see, I guess. I'm going to be doing a number 5 clipper blade on her. She's got really thick fur. As springtime is coming, so now owners want to get their dogs a little bit shorter because it has been growing out for a while, and with that snow, it tends to mat up quite a bit. So I'll be using a number 5 without any restraints, and then there won't be any editing to this film as well. So you'll be able to see the full grooming process. So hope you enjoy it. Please give me a thumbs up and a comment to let me know what you think. And of course, please subscribe if you haven't done so already. Man, look at that nice soft fur under there. So it doesn't take long for a difficult dog, well, especially a puppy. It doesn't take long for a difficult doggy groomed puppy to be a bit more relaxed. And some dogs that have had whatever happened to them in their previous grooming experience, that kind of lingers with them for a little bit longer. And it's hard to break that mistrust. But it does happen. If you've been watching, you could see that with Taser. He's one of my most difficult puppies that had a bad experience with the previous groomer. And it's taken him over a year. I think a year and a half, and he's finally calmed down. He's still got a little spunk in him, but much better guy. Good girl. Okay. We'll see how she does for her feet, as those are the most difficult part on her. But just by her demeanor here, she's much calmer. If you do have time to watch that first video, you will see what a different puppy she was, but usually when a puppy comes in, they're just quite nervous. And of course they don't like it. So why do they want to listen? They just like to test the boundaries. Just like anybody else learning the system. See what they can get away with, eh?
Good girl. Switch this one out. Not cooperating. Yeah, I'll turn this one. Okay. Good girl. Blades are getting dull. Might be time to switch them out. Okay. I always like to have three going at once. So when this happens, and of course they only go dull when you're using them, so. And a good girl. I'll turn you. Okay. Well, so far she is not going to be on the difficult doggy list anymore. Okay, a bit of a mat under there, so I'm going to use number 10. So I'm not digging in there, and I am going to lift the table up a bit too. I'm kind of hunched over. Good girl. Okay, okay. Okay. Perfect. Big clump in there, so it's nice to use the 10 so you're not digging. You're just kind of going to the dory. The door is right behind my shoulder here that she's sitting at. Oops. Good girl. This hair is actually growing back up into the ear, so I'm just pulling it down so I can cut it with the clippers. Pretty sure you're not interested in watching me. big clump under there too, so I might as well grab the 10 right now. You just like that corner, eh? Come on. Hey, stay. Really soft fur. Underneath all these curls. So all the curls are the Bichon. And then this soft fur underneath is all the Shih-Tzu. Quite a unique combination there. And the coloring. Make this beautiful girl. Can't stop that. Stay. My clippers got caught on part of the setup there. Twisting on me. Stinker. Come on this way. Okay, so I'm going to switch to number 7. Why do you have to go right on the edge? Me? I just like to be right there. Right here.
Thank you.
Okay. Just going to use a number 10. Just in that. That's your lady parts there. You don't really want to be digging in there with the number 7. Get their belly cleaned up too. Okay. Yeah, good girl. Alright, let's try these feet and see how she does. Like I said, this is only her third groom. I think it was her front feet that were the difficult ones. They're really thick with hair. Digging in there. And I know some groomers prefer to use clippers in there, but I still find their dogs are a little bit calmer. You'll see that I'll use clippers once in a while, especially when the pads are like really big, when they're a bigger dog. Where are you going? These scissors are getting dull. Time for a new pair of scissors. That's another thing. It's really important to have a good pair of sharp scissors on hand. It makes all the difference when you're trimming. No, no, no. Thank you. You have to stay. Let me do this. Good girl. Hey, no. Some people comment on how I'm twisting those feet too much. Basically, I just hold it and the dog kind of moves, trying to get away from me basically, but I just keep holding on because they're not going to twist themselves that it hurts. It may look like it hurts, but they're pretty flexible, so sometimes they're twisted up pretty good. Good girl. Oh. Just getting this fur on the end. Oh, and I just have somebody picking up, so I'm gonna take a little intermission here. We'll be right back. All right, and we are back.
Good girl. Hey, no. Oh, she's pulling bigger. There you go. Good girl, just stay. Yeah. Good girl. Hey, no. Maybe there were big claws on there. Okay, know. He's like, I just gotta see around there. What are you hiding from me? Yes, fine. It's a good girl. Yeah, she's pretty relaxed. Okay. You have to stay. No. Yeah. No, okay. Good girl. Good girl. Well, that can be a record. Hey, stay. Still getting closer. You cannot escape out the door. Alright. There we go. Okay. Done the nails and the feet. What a good girl. Look at that fluffy tail. We'll talk to the owners with all the staining here. I've heard and done, and I use it for my own dog, that if you give your dog filtered water rather than tap water, it'll help alleviate this. So I will pass that message along to these guys, and hopefully next time you won't see them so stained. this down. And start out with some fresh, clean fur in there. A little bit of matting right there. The end of it. What are you doing? He's leaning her head against the wall. It's so funny. You love the wall, eh? You're funny. Look at her. She just loves that wall. Thinning shears to get through that. Right, so that's all the matting in there. Yeah, good girl. Got it all out. It's in some here. A little bit pink in there, but for the most part still really healthy, so there's no wax buildup. It all comes out easy. Okay, this other ear. You gotta move. Not as much as the other ear. Ooh. Hey, Abel. There we go. Had her own little grooming session there. Yeah, that one really didn't look as much as the other one. got that twist. Again, really healthy. A little bit red again, but no real big buildup of wax or anything. There we go. Get your hair. Yep. Okay. We got the tail done, so we are ready for the bath. A little off the top. Okay. Just in case you don't like the blow dryer.
Good girl. Good girl. All up there.
see any soap residue, you want to rinse that out, because otherwise it'll, when it dries on their skin, it makes them itchy. Always make sure you get a good rinse. And that's kind of why I do the little squeegee here. Then I can see if any soap is left. Make sure I got it all out. Good girl. Okay, here we go. Up. Okay. Leave her in the towel a little bit. That kind of soaks up some of the water. I'll get the table all ready for her. Okay.
Thank you. there just because she likes to move. Okay, back to the number five. Come on, my mom will be over. Here we go. It's okay. Good girl. We're just about done. Well, just about done. Oil. There we go. There we go. Good girl. Thank you and your cream. I know the door is there, but we're gonna have to wait. We're done. Okay, let's flip that up a little bit. Not a big fan of the blow dryer on her head and ears. That's why I do like to trim them up before the bath. Sometimes it's hard to blow dry them. Especially when they're only here for an hour. Good guy did a corner. That's your safety spot, huh? Okay, yeah. Good girl, it's okay. Back to the corner for the grand finale. That's where the toothbrushes are. Okay. Just about done, baby. Nope. Okay, going down. Nothing but nice teeth. By changing the water, that should also change the staining here too. Alright, so thanks for watching, everyone. I will attach that other video here coming up here at the end. So hopefully you enjoy that as well. You have a great day, and thanks for watching, and please let me know what you think about the video in the comments, and like and subscribe. You ready to go? Okay, good girl. Okay, let's go. You know what this is. All right. Aren't you cute? Okay.